Summers, welcome back. This week you guys voted, and so almost unanimously we have chosen to do dinosaurs. Sorry, Santiago, we'll get you in the next one. We have a lot of really cute activities for you, so this video and the next one are going to be dinosaur themed. I don't have any links in the description below because the activities this week are really simple, so I'm just going to kind of go over them with you very briefly. The first one that we're doing is these little clothespin dinosaur puppets. So you guys got these little handouts that have the dinosaurs on them, and the way that they're set up is so that you can cut them out, glue them to your clothespins, and when they're done, it's going to be like a little front and back. Now, I did my faces the same, but the dinosaurs are set up in such a way where if you wanted, you could have one face this way and then a different expression on the other side, however you want to do it. The next one that we're going to go over is the shadow tracing. So we sent out some dinosaurs for you guys and some big pieces of paper. You're just going to find, once the weather cooperates with us, take those pieces of paper outside, set up your dinosaurs however you want so that the shadow works out best for you, and then just trace those shadows, color them in however you want to do. Get creative, enjoy that one. And then the last thing that we're doing is some dinosaur eggs. They're frozen dinosaur eggs. You guys got some balloons with tiny dinosaurs on the inside, and all you're gonna do is just put some water inside of the balloon just enough to make a little egg shape. Tie it up, put them in the freezer. If you want to, you can add a couple of drops of food coloring to make it a little bit more colorful, bright. And then once you have your frozen egg, it's up to you to decide how you're going to get the egg open. So you can either just leave it and let it melt naturally. You can put it in warm water. You can put salt on the egg. You can crack it open. However you want to do it is going to be just fine. Let the kids explore. Mine really like this one. They like breaking their eggs open, boys. So, I have a story for you guys about what happens when dinosaurs get sick. And other than that, I think that wraps everything up, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I hope you enjoy these activities. And as always, thank you so much for continuing to participate. It means really, really, really a lot to all of us. So again, thank you, thank you, thank you. And we'll see you next time. Bye. Dinosaurs Get Well Soon by Jane Yolen and Mark Teague. What if a dinosaur catches the flu? Does he whimper and whine in between each achoo? Does he drop dirty tissues all over the floor? Does he fling all his medicine out of the door? Does he flip off his covers with tooth and with tail? Does he dump out his juice and get sick in a pail? Does a dinosaur wail? What if a dinosaur goes to the dock? Does he drag all his feet till his mom is in shock? Does he hold his mouth closed when he's told, open wide? Does he scream? Is he mean? Does he run off and hide? Does he push back each drink, spit his pills in the sink? Does he make a big stink? Is that what you think? No. He drinks lots of juice. He gets lots of rest. He's good at the doctors, 'cause doctors know best. He uses a hanky on mouth and on nose. He snuggles right down underneath the bedclothes. He takes all his medicine without a fight. He closes his eyes. He whispers good night. Then Mama and Papa tiptoe out the door. Get well, little dinosaur.